H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Okay, so we will quickly go through the actually topics, whatever we discussed yesterday.
If you don't mind, yesterday homework, can you please put it in the chat again?
Yesterday homework in the chat. Okay. I'm anyhow discussing the programs itself. Don't worry. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. So the first one was using while loop. Okay. So what we are going to do while loop is finding sum of numbers from 1 to 100. Okay. So see this guy now. So what is the here? What we need to find out here is 1 plus 2 plus 3. Okay. Plus 4 plus so on up to 100. That is our aim. Okay. So now if you see, very simple, we can apply loop here because it is repetitive numbers from 1 to 100. Okay. And every time the increment will be 1. Okay. So why it will be 1? Because we need to actually find the sum of numbers from 1 to 100. So that way we need to have increment 1. Okay. That is true. And then we need to start with our number with 1. So our initializer, whoever, whatever it is, for example, any variable starts with 1 and we get the count up to 100, which is 101. Okay. So that way. So now if you see the same thing I have taken here, I initially declared my variable as a equal to 1. Okay. So which is my start of the series. Then I want to check until a less than or equal to 100. That means a value from 1 to 100. If you see the increment here, a plus plus. So first time my a value will be 1. So in the next iteration, my a value will be 2. In the next iteration, my a value will be 3 and so on. Okay, so that's how. Now, fine. We are actually able to print without this. But how do I find the sum of all the numbers? So for that reason, what I've taken initially my sum value as 0. Okay, because I need to find sum of all the numbers. So my sum value I have taken as 0. Now, what I need to do every time I will get a number from A, which I need to really sum it. So that means my intention is here 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus and so on. So that means this number every time I'm getting in my loop or iteration. So here what I do, I just do the same sum to that number. So if you see here, first time what happened, my sum equal to sum plus a I given. What is the initial value of sum and initial value of a? Sum is 0, a is 1. So first time the value here will be 0 plus 1. Correct? So the first time value will be 1. Fine. Now what is the a value? A plus plus a is already 1. What is the a value now? 2. Correct? So next time it will go again here to the loop line number 9. Now it will check either 2 less than 101. Yes, it is true. Now what is the existing sum value? 1. Now what is the formula here or expression here? Sum equal to sum plus a. Because existing a value is 1 for sum, 1 plus a value is 2 because of the previous a plus plus. So that way now 1 plus 2 is 3. Now what will be new a value? 3, because it was 2, it will be incremented by 3. Now again it will go here and check 3 less than 101, true. Sum value already 3, and we again you are adding sum plus a is 3. So 3 plus 3, 9. Okay, then again your a value will be 4. Now again it will go here, a less than 101, yes, true. Sum already value is 9, 9 plus 4 will be 13. So like this, it will continue until your A value is 100. Once A value reach 101, this condition becomes false. Okay, this condition becomes false. I no need to print sum within the loop. Why? Because I want to find the total sum of all the integers. So that is the reason. If I print sum here, it will find every some value for every integer addition, which I don't want. So that is the reason what I did. I printed my sum at the end of after the loop. That means whatever be the sum value I had, that will be my final result. So if you see here, that's what it is. Okay. So now if you see, just print this guy, you will see 50-50. So it has actually summed from 1 to 100. Okay, it has added the numbers from 1 to 100. That is how it is. Similarly, if you want to change it to 200, no problem. It will find 200. See that? Like this. Okay, so it is very pretty simple and straightforward. You are using while loop because the question is to use while loop here. I'm using while loop because while loop we do have the initializer, condition and the incrementer. Okay, so our sum should be within the while loop. If you are going outside of while loop, that means you are not evaluating the each number. Okay, so that's how it will be. And you don't need to print within the loop. Why? Because you don't want to print for each number sum. You want to print at the end the total sum value. So that way it is printed after while loop. Clear? Anybody have any concern? Okay, cool. Similarly, let us do the do while also. This is also same like numbers, but however, we do have an average. So how do we find the average generally? First, we need to find the sum of the numbers. Then we can divide it by number of numbers. Suppose if I say 1 plus 1 plus 2 plus up to 50 by average means the total numbers will be 1 plus 1 to 50, it will be 50 numbers. So we need to actually be divided by number of numbers, which is 50. Okay, so that is how it will be. Now if you see the same thing, I applied I equal to 1, sum equal to 0, because here the only difference is we will be applying our while condition at the end, because this is do while and the same thing. Now what happens after my loop here, my I value will be 51. Only when my I value is 51, it will be actually quitting the loop here. So my I value will be 51 because it is a average. Average generally will be a floating value. Why? Because it is actually having division in it. Okay, division in it. So I have taken my result, average result, as float RES, which is actually initialized to zero initially, then result equal to sum divided by number of numbers. Here I value is actually 51, so that is the reason I given 50 minus 1. So otherwise you can even directly give 50 numbers also. This is also valid, no problem. Here I value is 51. Why? Because until 50 it is within the loop. Once it is 51, it is actually outside, it becomes false and then it will come out of the loop. So that way the latest I value at this statement was 51, but we should not divide it by 51, we should divide it by 50 only, because number of numbers are 1 to 50. So that is the reason I given I minus 1 here. Okay, now I'm printing my sum as well as I'm printing my average. Simple. Okay, let's see that. See here, sum is 1 to 75. This one is I value, which is 51. See here, after the loop. So that is the reason I made it here, I minus 1. Okay, so now sum equal to 1 to 75. If we divide it by 50, its number of numbers, then it is 25.5. So because the division generally, there are chances that you will get the decimal value. So we must take something float or decimal or float or double to get this value. So that is the reason here for sum we don't require, because it is integer addition only. When you add integers, what happens? The result will be integer only. So that way you will see sum as integer value only. However, your average may be a float value. Okay, any questions there? Cool.
Because here hello Srinivas.
Yeah.
Yeah, because here we took sum as integer, that's why we did typecasting.
Yes, obviously. Because both are integer. Sum is integer, I is integer. So that is the reason what you need to do is typecasting. If you don't do also, it automatically asks you there. See there. Okay. See result integer. Even it don't to hear, no problem, because it is a division, it automatically takes. Okay.
Yeah, if you don't typecast, it will giving the answer as only 25, right?
Yes, that is the reason.
Yeah.
Okay. Because this is integer, this is integer. So that is the reason we need to typecast it. Okay. See now. This is correct value. Okay. Okay, let's see the interesting one, Fibonacci series. Okay, so first, before this one, let us understand what this series is. Okay, remember this. So we start with either 0 or 1. Okay, it is fine, up to you. Current value can be 0 or 1, that's fine. Now, suppose let's say we start with 0. So next value will be 1. Okay, so first two values are fixed here. First two values are fixed generally. Either 01 you can take or 11, it is up to you, not a problem. Now if you see, what will be next value will be, the next value is sum of previous two numbers that you need to remember here. Sum of previous two numbers. So what are previous two numbers here is 01. 0 plus 1, 1. Fine. Next, 1 plus 1, 2. Next, 2 plus 1, 3. Next, 3 plus 2, 5. Next, 5 plus 3, 8. Next, 13 and so on. So this is how Fibonacci series is generally generated. Now, let's see how do we do. So here, we asked to use for loop. Okay, for for loop, you can do number of numbers. For example, we will give some 25 numbers we want to generate. So that way I've taken here, see here. So first, initially what I taken is, I started with 11, not 00, 01, I started with 11, okay? Now, if you see, I have taken the first one as previous one. P1 means previous one. P2 means previous two. So these two I have taken initially as is 11. See here. Now, my current value I want to calculate. Initially, I have taken my current value as 0 because I need to calculate it with previous 1 and 2. So that way I have taken here. Okay, now see this. I'm applying, actually I'm printing as is 11 first. Okay, here if you observe, I used print only, not print line. Okay, why? Because I don't want to print each number in different line. I want to print all the numbers in the same line, one after another. Okay, so that way. If you see here, I first given P2, and then I given comma, then I given P1. Okay, so after that I given comma again. Why? Because next number should be printed after that. Fine. Now, this is a for loop I applied. So I need to repeat it 24 times. You can take either number of times or whatever it is. So for example, here,
we are having problem today, I think.
Is it?
Can you please repeat that, Srinivas?
Yes, Srinivas, again, we are having problem today, I think. It's getting disconnected in between voice.
Okay. Let's give a couple of minutes. Okay. Is it fine now? I think this GoTo meeting is having issues sometimes.
Yes, yes, Srinivas, it's
yeah,
fine.
Yes, it's fine now.
Okay.
Sure. Yeah, but so the problem is it may disconnect in between again. That's
no
the problem.
Give me a shout whenever you feel I'm not audible. Okay. Okay. Whenever
you think it's a problem with your Wi-Fi.
No, my Wi-Fi is very strong though. Actually, it is 75 Gbps speed. Mbps speed, by the way. Okay. Because not only this class, right? I will take other cells. Nobody have complained. Okay. Actually, this go-to meeting sometimes behave like that.
No, I can see only like one bar on your Wi-Fi at the bottom. Taskbar.
Where? No. This is actually, if you see here, my Wi-Fi speed somewhere between 75 Mbps. Okay.
All right.
Okay. Let's see. That's not a problem. So if I'm not audible, let me know. Okay. So this is how the sequence is generally generated. Okay. So if you see this guy now, I have taken P1, P2, as I said, and then current value I need to evaluate. So current value, we always evaluate using for loop because this we asked using for loop. Now see this guy. So I want to generate it 24 times only. That means first 25 numbers I want to print. So that is the reason I have taken here. Okay, it is up to you if you want to take more. Now, what would be the current value? current value is always sum of previous two. I have already taken my previous one and two here, so that way this is actually p1 plus p2. Okay, so now here I calculated the sum, fine. But remember here, whenever you calculated the sum, for example, 1 comma 1, 2, this is the current value, fine. Now, to calculate the next current value, your existing current value should become p1, correct? And your existing p2 value should become, p1 value should become p2. To calculate the next current value. Okay, so this will be your current, which will be 3. That is how it is. Similarly, once you calculate 3, now what will happen? Your current value will be 5. Your existing current value will become P1. Correct? And the existing P1 becomes P2. And this one will be not there. So that is how generally we calculate. So what that means? After you are calculating the current value, you are assigning your current existing value into P1. So this is what I'm doing it here. First, I'm printing it as is. Then your P2 becomes P1. That means this value becomes P1 here. Okay. So this value becomes P1 means what happened? What is P2 here? P2 is this one. Okay. So P1, P2 this way. P1, P2. So now this should become your P1 and your current value should become this should become your P1 and current value should become P2. So that way what happened? P2 equal to P1 means here my current value becomes P. This one becomes P1. This one will go away. Okay. This one will go away. Now after this statement, what is a P1? P1 should be current value. My current value is this one. Okay, so this one become P1 and sorry, this one will be P2. Okay, so that is how. Now for the next one, see this guy, 8. This will be your current, right? 3 plus 5 till here. Now what is P2 equal to P1? That means this will become P2 equal to P1. So now your P2 becomes P1 and P1 becomes current. So that way these two will be calculated. So next time this one will be vanished. This one will become P2. This one will become P1. So that way you'll be assigning using these two. Okay. You'll be assigning using these two. So now what will happen here is actually whenever you are actually evaluating the current value, every time you are resetting it to using these two statements. So now again for the next one, which is the current, 8 plus 5, 13 is the current. So once we calculate current, what will happen again? To calculate the next value, this will be vanished. This will become P2, P1. Now this will be your new current value, which is 13 plus 8, 21, like this. So for that reason, we need to set these values. Okay, so then what happened? Your current will be again generated. First time it will be 2, 1 plus 1. So next time it will be 2 plus 1, 3. Next time it will be 3 plus 2, 5. Next time it will be 3 plus 5, 8, and so on. It will print the same values here. And if you see the numbers also, it will just readjust that accordingly. Okay, it will just readjust that accordingly. That's it. Now let us see that whether it is generated here or not. See here. Now what is the first value? 11, it is printed as we printed here. This is the statement. Okay, fine. Current here need to be calculated. What is the current? P1 and P2. So what is the P1 and P2? 1 plus 1, 2. See here. Now what happened? P2 becomes P1. Okay. P1 becomes P2. P2 becomes P1. And then P1 becomes current. That means these two it became. Now again you are printing P1 plus P1. So 1 plus 2, 3. Similarly, it again changed. These two will become P1, P2. Again, current 5. After this, these two will become P1 and P2. Current value 8. After that, these two will become P1 and P2. Current value 13. And so on, it will print up to some numbers. I given some 24, so it is up to you. For example, if you want to print more, you can print it, not a problem. See this guy. See? Like this. Okay. So even our integer doesn't suit here. Okay. So that is the reason it did a cyclic one. It must be long. Okay. So it must be long in this case. That is how it will be. Okay. So that is how you will generally see. So that is the reason here. Generally, we print up to 20 numbers or 25 numbers only. Because if you go beyond, your integer itself won't be sufficient. And you must create this as long. Okay. So that is how it will be. So these are called Fibonacci series. Remember, once you calculate your previous, see, 1 plus 1 comma 1, let's say 2. Now, this is current, okay? This is previous 1. This is previous 2. For the next value, your current becomes P1. Your P1 becomes P2. So that is what it is. P2 is P1. That means P1 is assigned to P2, which is this one. Current is assigned to P1, which is this one. So this one will be vanished now. We don't use this. Okay. Similarly, 3 will be your current. Now, for next value, what will become? This will become P2 again. See this. P2 will be assigned to P1. So your P1 will be P2. Now, current will be assigned to P1. So that means your current will be P1. That's it. So now this will go away. So this is how the calculation happens in the Fibonacci series. Clear? So apart from this, only difference will be this. You need to understand every time whenever you make the new value, your previous two values will change. That you are doing it here. Okay, your current becomes P1, your P1 becomes P2. Simple. Your current becomes P1, your P1 becomes P2. That's it. So these two are the key for this one. If without these two, your series won't work. Okay.
So Srinivas, here the for loop condition is only using for the looping, right?
Yeah. Number of items which you are printing. That's it. Nothing else. I'm printing some 25. Items. Okay. That's it. Okay.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So if you want only, you can do one more thing also. For example, you want to apply for loop for your sum. You want to print only the numbers up to 1000. In that case, what you can do here, you can do sum less than 200 also. In that case, not sum, current value. Okay. Current value less than 1000. That means you can print only numbers which are before 1000. That means up to here you may print. That's it. Okay. Or maybe up to here also, because less than 1000, when you say once it is below 1000, it will enter current value also. So current value, this also become only up to here you can print. But I didn't do that. Let us do only few numbers. Okay, that is fine. So that is the reason I give it like this. Okay. Yeah. Tell me.
Yeah, what is this? Yeah, system dot out print, you said, right?
Huh. That okay. Time only. Generally, what happens is whenever you give print line or print ln, what happens is everything, it will be printed whatever you give in the single line only, correct? Now, same thing here. See here, I give a print line here. Every number, apart from these two, every number will be printed in different line. I don't want to do that. So that is the reason. See here. These two printed from here, fine. But this one and all printed different line. Why? Because you have print ln, which is print line. So every time it will add new line. To avoid that, I don't want to print like this one. I want to print everything in a single line. So what I did, I don't use ln. Whenever you don't use print ln or print line, what happens is everything will be printed in a single line only. So that is the reason. See here. That's it. Okay.
Srinivas, we are giving the condition for less than 1000. So we can use that command on line 15 also, right?
Yes. It is up to you. Okay. Yeah, no problem. It is up to you guys. So I given here first 25 numbers. That's it. That way. Okay.